A lot of stupid questions, maybe.
Oh.
No, that's a good question, but that's outside of the control of this board.
Yeah, I mean, I read that, you know, we're talking with Laura, that a lot of times they'll take our suggestion.
Yes.
So, you know, I don't know.
Well, we got a real problem, because we've got Trair, Dyson, Tama, and Toledo. Those four cities really have to be in their own districts.
Yeah.
Because, so you got the fifth one, which is gonna be a big district. And that's about where it is.
Trair and Dyson always has been together.
That's right.
But you can't put those two together with making five districts.
No, no.
That's too many.
No, they have too many.
Yeah.
And then the next thing that falls into place, state of Iowa again, legislative districts.
Yeah.
They carved our county up in the eastern half.
Yeah, I know.
Just nuts.
They were talking how hard it is setting up the precincts because of that.
That, and setting up a ballot, think about it. Because each ballot for each precinct, it's going to be tainted somehow, or different.
Different, yeah.
I call it tainted, because it's, because the state of Iowa screwed up it. It used to be quite easy, didn't it, Joe? Until they passed that law.
I just, we don't try and figure it out, I'll be honest with you.
Well, I'll join the group.
I admit, they must have got the clocks straight, is that right?
That's, it's 19.
See, look.
Is it 9:30?
So it's still 2:30. Morning.
There's the three ladies with all the.
Yeah, they have all the.
I'm gonna sit back here and take notes. You all know everybody, right?
We introduced ourselves.
Okay, all right. So Mike Winsey, Richard Arp, and Joe Bowl are redistricting committee. Karen is my election administrator. Maureen is the GIS administrator. She does maps and everything for us. So these two have been working on a couple scenarios. Well, they've worked on more than two, but they've come up with two to present, just to start with, if we needed something to start with, to do this redistricting into five districts. We have 17,135. So it's divided by five, and that's how many you can have in each.
3,400.
Yep. Yeah, each supervisor district, plus or minus 1%, which is 35. So you can have 35 more or 35 less. Something that changed 2 years ago with redistricting is the ability for the county to set supervisor districts was taken away and given to the legislative services agency. But we're supposed to come up with the election precincts first, send it to them, and then they set the supervisor districts, which is backwards to me and to the state and everybody at the Secretary of State. So what we did 2 years ago was we kind of still went ahead and set up or played with supervisor districts and then set our precincts based on that, and sent our supervisor map to the LSA with a suggestion of this. We based it off of this. We know it can be changed. So even though you guys might approve something in the next week or two, they could come through and change it. But we're gonna make a suggestion. Whether they accept it or not, that's fine. And then if they change the supervisor districts completely different, then we'll have to meet some more to make our precincts fit that. Something that's a little more unique this time too is you can't have two supervisor districts at the same precinct. So that could cause us to have more precincts. 2 years ago, based on the census and when we redid this, we cut our precincts down to save money. So our goal, I'm just being totally transparent, is to try not to add too many more election precincts to save money. To do that, we might have some people that'll have to travel to a different place to vote, so, and voters will be upset about that, but our hands are tied. So if I have to purchase more equipment, we will. But
it's not only just a savings to the county, but it's really hard to find election workers.
Yes,
yeah.
That's the other hard part.
Yeah.
So with that in mind, that's kind of how we came up with this. Maureen's an expert on the software for the mapping, so she can show you that. Also, the precincts are set on census blocks, which are not blocks, they're not square, they're weird, where we are used to townships that are square. So we have to try to make those fit together. So they've been working on it pretty hard for a couple months. So they've got a couple scenarios they'll present to you. You can play with it, you can suggest something completely different. We can bring it up on the computer and see if we can make it work. Okay? And then all you guys need to do is appoint a chairperson, and if you're okay with that, I'll be your secretary. Take the notes. So I'll let you guys get started, okay?
The 17th.
Any other nominations?
Yep, yep, in the last census.
Okay, last census, okay, thank you.
Okay, so what I did when I was playing.
I'll accept it. Is that okay, Richard?
That's okay. I'm the new guy.
Okay.
As soon as I'm as old as you are, I'll accept it too.
So before I started playing around, I went through all of our townships and everything and got the numbers for each township, which would, so Toledo here is at 2,780, includes the town of Toledo and the township of Toledo. So I use those numbers to help play around with, to get my map to work. So Maureen, before I started doing anything, did these maps. And what she did is she kind of went across to see what the numbers would be, and she went up and down to see what the numbers would be to try to split the supervisors for that district. And as you can see, those numbers don't work out. There's too many, too little ones. So then I started to get involved, and I tried doing that the first time. Another thing to keep in mind is these four townships up here, which is Perry, Clark, Geneseo, and Buckingham. They are also a different Senate district, and so that throws you into a different precinct. So if we would have went with this, these two townships up here would not be able to vote in Traer or Dysart because it's a different supervisor district.
Buckingham.
Yeah, that would, because it.
Geneseo.
Yeah. Right. Sorry. So I would have had make them go over to Macon, and that's, I wouldn't have wanted to do that because there'd be lots of complaints.
Oh yeah.
And then plus there's too many people with just those two townships together. So that did not work. This one we split. You came up with this map. The numbers for the supervisors worked out fine, but the getting the legals would be a nightmare. And then as you can see, I said that there'd have to be extra precincts for the way to split. And that would cost a lot extra plus getting all the workers. So that one didn't work. So then I played around.
Okay,
nobody would be happy with that.
It's all about the numbers.
Yeah. We're trying really hard to work with these numbers, and they just don't.
I mean, I can understand like Traer or Dysart.
If we had one more town about the size of Traer or Dysart,
it'd
be fine. But four are easy. It's a fifth.
So then I came up with this one as my first plan. That would work. I still don't care for it for the fact that Carroll Township, and Crystal would now be going to Blackbird to vote. That'd be a long drive for them. Buckingham would still get to vote with Traer because they'd be in the same supervisor district and they're still messing with Senate district. So those would work out that way. But all these other ones. So I didn't really care for that. And then so this is Spring Creek Township. So these people here would have to travel all the way down to Montour because they wouldn't be able to vote in Garwin, which is this little square here. So they would be traveling all the way down here.
Tell me, where's, let's see, highways?
We don't have Bristol and a little part of Howard Township would go to Gladbrook to vote. A little part, a little bit of Carlton Township would come up to Gladbrook to vote. The city of Garland and a little bit of Carlton Township here could still vote in Garland. We might take that precinct away from them. And then some of the rest of Howard can either go to Toledo or to Garland to vote. This part of Carlton would then go to Montour. This also includes the settlement. The city of Tama, Tama Township, and Otter Creek worked out perfect with their numbers. And then this also leaves Vining and Elbron alone as far as precinct, but just a little portion of York Township would then go up to Cloutier. So I mean, the most complaints we probably get would be from the people in Howard maybe, that would have to go somewhere else, and definitely Carlton is the biggest one. I feel like the people in Buckingham having to go to Dyser isn't a huge...
Where do they go now?
They would go to, they're, right now they go to Traer.
Okay.
But they would have to go somewhere different due to it being a different supervisor district.
People up here have their own...
Yep, they're, they would stay the same.
So are you adding any precincts?
No, this keeps the precincts exactly the same.
Oh.
We just have to split where people go. I mean, we still have the Garland precinct, but not all the regular Garland people would go there. They still have to split.
So, okay, where are the highways? 63 here.
Do you have a map that you give that?
Years ago, Grant and Lincoln were the same district. Then Grant moved into the church.
Oh, perfect.
I just, you know, it gives me more perspective.
You bet. Yeah, that's what they choose. Maps and different stuff.
So, which district is coming?
Garland would be in District 4 now.
And that would be with most of the team, most of Toledo.
I played with a lot of numbers, and I couldn't, I could come up with maybe three districts or four districts relatively easily. And the fifth one was a nightmare.
It was, yep.
It was a
nightmare. And we don't want to do too much splitting within townships, because then that's a nightmare for legal descriptions.
Okay, school board meeting.
You say Garland is there.
Garland, I don't think so.
Oh, okay, can
that make sense? How are you?
Where's this?
That's the last one that we're looking at. I believe Marine is at the highway out of, I'm sorry, what's it? I believe it's, yeah, coming out of there on the what it calls site.
Oh,
or
really
not necessarily, you got to bring up the map.
Okay. When they're done looking at it, yeah. Is there too many, because we're afraid to change?
We're afraid of that little bit of a change.
Yes.
Or section, even by section, they're spread.
You say Elbron?
Yep, Elbron and Vining should still be included in the yellow.
Just to get the numbers to match.
Correct.
Okay. They're in the same center.
Yes, yes. The only, these four up here are the only ones that have a different center district. Everybody else in Tama County is the same.
So you would have to add a second polling place in Traer? Second precinct?
No, right now they still have their own, just the
okay.
One, because we make Buckingham go to Dyser.
Okay, but...
the reason why Buckingham can't...
I thought you said that different Senate districts that have their own voting.
As long as they're within the same Senate district, Cunningham will be in District 1. That makes it different than District 3, so they cannot go to Trail.
Okay.
And go to the same precinct.
Okay. So these people here are coming to Trail too? Another point.
So right now, a part of Crystal goes to Gladbrook. So you guys can decide that. If you want Crystal to go to, right, if you want Crystal to go to Perry, they sure could. Right now, half of them already go to Gladbrook. So it's up to you.
That doesn't make any difference.
Yeah. But yes.
Whatever has been working good.
No, I mean.
You hate to ask people to change where they go for.
Around paying at a square hole. You gotta do the best.
This proposal, you don't have to change precincts.
Correct. And all of our precincts stay the same as far as where they're at. It's just going to change who goes to them.
Okay. Changing some of the people where they go.
Right.
And I think people understand, you know, knowing we're switching to 5, there's going to be some different polling places. Okay.
Yeah, there has to be. There's no way we could keep everybody. If we kept everybody at the same, we would have an astronomical amount of precincts.
That southern district and the northern district are the two that will have the most miles for the supervisor on that part.
Right. But
that's part of it.
You know what District 1 is right now is.
Oh, that's a terrible shape.
Area.
But that's.
Yeah. I mean.
That's the way it was.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't really have a choice.
Depends upon the numbers of people.
Oh, I hate splitting townships.
Me too.
Oh, I hate splitting sections by sections, but there's really no other choice on that part.
I really tried.
If we had 4 districts, it would not be a problem.
This one, I really tried to keep it all square.
3 was bad enough.
It won't work. Like I said, that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, this one looks cleaner.
Right.
At first.
First glance. Yeah. I really tried to keep it square. Because it would be so much easier.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So when we said this in, how much review do they do? I mean, you know, I can't imagine them sitting down.
Right.
Yeah.
I think if we did the legwork for them,
Before they accepted it, I hope they would accept it.
In our recommendations?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'd like to see on a map for sure where that break off is by Garwin.
Okay.
I mean,
Maureen, she's the best one for that.
Okay.
This keyboard is so touchy.
That's 47, the Garwin Road.
I mean, is this the Garwin Road here? Or, I mean, it's the way it looks.
It's a county road.
That's, this right here is actually.
You want me to use the one that says Karen 2?
I think I labeled it. I think I labeled it final.
Cross,
then well, then it angles up and it crosses.
Jogs down and then goes back up to it. Looks like that to there. Because then that road actually comes down but
right.
Half a mile there. Yeah. Okay. I mean, that, to me, that looks about as good as you could do.
But it still kept Elbron and Viney together, so.
Yeah, and I'd like to see that, you know, I'd like to see a map like this here, for sure. You know, these, you know, precincts that are one color, but
right.
To know for sure where the edging is. And this one here, too.
Yeah, that's a mean one. There's no way to make it simple.
No.
Karen, you want to kind of show me which one you want? There it is. I finally found it. Okay.
I should minimize the trouble there, you know.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we're going to have people complaining.
Why are we going
here? I've went here for years. Mm-hmm. You know, but people got to realize.
how many times a year, you know, it's like, you can drive to where you go or do absentee if you can't drive.
And you have between 7 and 8, that's a pretty big span there.
Yeah, there's options.
Okay, I got that.
You know where to go.
Yeah, so they wanna see, don't wait till you have the time, you're not sure.
Can you do that?
Exactly.
I'd have to go to my computer and do a shape file of the roads and pull it in, but I don't know how it's gonna really show.
Can you come and just show us on the map here?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's a red line on those county roads.
I basically wanna know how we're, you know, is this the Garland Road here? And then it jogs down.
The real problem is going to, is in the auditor's office when you prepare the ballots for respective school districts, not only supervisors districts, but now you've got some real problems when you develop that ballot. For the respective precincts. They were in the state of Iowa.
We have to keep it in school district.
A math work. But then we did ourselves too.
Well, change it again.
Well, the way it looks like it jogs down.
Did all Iowa do redistricting for school districts?
I just wanna know where the line is.
This area, but it's within it that they need, like, they have director districts, 1, 2, 3.
Does it stay?
Driving that road many times, you come out of Garland, jog north.
Yeah.
Quarter mile straight across.
But the line on that, there shows just a little bit.
Yeah.
And it might be going by the, section then also in the township.
It's getting old, but.
I don't think the roads changed that much.
No.
No.
I wanna know where it's at, so.
Well.
That's her department, so.
Those areas, right at the elevator and the sign.
If you check down this, zoning one, it's got the precincts and the roads.
What were those big maps down that have the roads on them, guys?
And it has the precincts on it.
Yeah.
It's from 2014, but.
Yeah.
Let's get to carry this down.
Oh, yeah.
People don't know. Switching through the.
Well, we won't be the target, but if we are, up in there.
They're on our car.
You do, you probably am too.
I was on the school board, no kidding.
Yeah.
I know what it's like.
School board.
Thank you, sorry.
Just wanna make sure.
That was the one area I never ventured into. Always told that's purely emotional.
Not as bad as being on the church council.
Church board is. I was on the church council.
Yeah.
Found there were a lot of people that were not Christian. I thought they were, you know, then you read 29.
That's the word.
I should have the option.
Yeah.
63.
There's 96. What are you thinking of using highways or design method or is it access?
I just wanna know, where the line is. And how far south that jogs. And then I'd like to know too over here.
York one is pretty much just this top line of sections. You know, it's choppy in this one. Not sure how much more you want, but that's where.
My farms are right here.
That's where E29 and 63 break on that.
So. So there's, what is it, mile square?
Each township is 36 square miles.
That section.
And it's 1 mile square per section, correct?
Right, okay. That looks like 1 1/4 sections, if you, that's section, section, that section is spread. by the highway.
So it's the section A. Section A here.
Yeah, yeah, looks like.
Okay, down to 250.
Which is that in the corner? Let me think, you guys, okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know where, when you say that, I know where that's at.
Fire protection, you know, okay.
Jogging is in this area. Across here. Yeah. And I have no exact blue lips there. Just in case I get some heat from these guys.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I bet this is actually what it takes.
Do you guys want to look on here and see how census blocks work, which is what forces us to do a certain way?
Sure.
It's not fun.
No.
I might have said a few choice words.
I think everything should be square.
It should be.
I know, I wish.
Oh, I see, okay. No, that makes sense.
So, for example, if we try to, say, put this one into here, and I won't say that, Karen.
Are you running?
We try to grab that census block to go in with that. It raises, I don't know if it changed the number any or not. I didn't pay attention to what it was. Let me go back to the other. But that's what it does. It doesn't allow you to break these down any more than they are.
You can't break, you can't break census blocks, correct?
No. So I don't think that even changed the number any. Oops, wrong one. No, it didn't change the number any. And this shows, this is where we're watching as we are doing census blocks to try to get the numbers as close as possible. For example, okay, let's take Elbera. Is that Elbera?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I'm going to grab all of this in here. It's going to change from 5. How much it throws it off. If he has 183 too much, 163, I don't know.
So what is the total variation from one? I mean,
these are the total target deviations,
okay,
that we're showing.
So from what's the rate? It's what, 20, 22?
32.
32.
And 35 is our max.
Yep.
Within the 1%, yeah.
Okay.
And this is going to be extremely difficult legal description, and we're also trying to avoid that.
Mm-hmm. But that looks like the only place you're going to have a hard time.
Yeah, yeah, the rest was pretty clean. Yeah.
Yeah.
See on here where the highways are and where they come through.
So you had to basically sit at the computer and try and move blocks.
And Karen knows as well as I do.
That 1%.
Yes. Too bad we couldn't go forward.
Always District One.
District One's big too.
Right.
I think they kind of were anyway, weren't they?
District One.
District One, yeah.
Okay. So how big was District, District Two? The one that's to Tama?
They had a lot of the east, northeast down to Toledo, for two.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
Because I know Chelsea.
I think east half.
Chelsea's clear up here with number one.
Northern part.
Well, on the, what current?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was. Well, at least we all have three districts in Toledo, but maybe that would have helped. And then.
Well, if our city council, we don't want three districts.
No, oh, good Lord, I can never figure that one out.
Right, yeah.
I was happy when I came here, man. I think the auditors were too.
District Two, well, this district.
Not a lot of change.
Not a whole lot of change, other than loose.
They'll get more, look at Chelsea, the other half of Richland, and that part of York.
They're adding territory.
And just a little bit up here in Carlton.
Yeah, whereas the rest of the districts are shrinking. Is that my, maybe I'm.
Yep.
Area wise, yeah.
Simplifying it.
Because they're the most popular.
Area wise, the population, yeah, correct.
Yeah, we have a declining population, but we're adding more districts.
Yeah.
The voters told us we had to. Whether you agree with it or not.
I don't agree with it.
I mean, I'm really shocked that Toledo Town, what, 2700, I mean, I thought we'd afford that, you know.
Yeah.
And you know, you couple that with, there are less people living in the country, less houses, you know, so obviously your area's gonna get bigger.
Well, I'm not sure how much a legislative service bureau gets involved in challenging the plan. I don't know.
From what I read in all this information, basically the outside, you know, as long as you get your numbers within
it's a numbers game.
Within their, you know, parameter.
We can get it when they have the variance, yeah.
And you're.
You know, it's how long it take you to do that, my God.
Long time.
I did as many as I could, and then I showed Karen how to do it.
Was it more than 12 back?
She knows the precincts, so she played.
Was it more than 12 back on Saturday night?
I think the important part is we're keeping the precincts, voting precincts.
That was our biggest goal.
Because that is a major expense now.
Yes, it is.
We used to have 36 voting precincts.
Yes, we did.
What is it?
Then we shrunk it to 14?
13?
13.
So does that plan add any more then, or?
Does not add any more.
That's good.
It'll just have some people voting in different areas, different areas, precincts at least.
And that was gonna happen anyway.
Well, when they change the legislative district, that threw another wrinkle in the whole issue.
Whatever you do, even with this, if you're adding, you know, some people are gonna have.
That's right.
Can you tell from that what the largest distance someone may have to change to go vote for?
Probably the ones up in Buckingham.
I say, yeah, I'd say
but if they're going from Traer to Dysart, that mileage wouldn't actually be too different, would it?
But these are the people north of Traer. You want to look at that?
So right now, this is Buckingham. They go down to Traer.
Oh.
Yeah, they'll be going over there.
An extra, what, 5 miles?
Yeah.
Five minutes.
They can go have something. There's a restaurant there, right?
Yes.
Go out to eat.
Yeah.
And they can always
go to Harper's afterwards.
Yes, there you go.
So now you guys will need to decide, do you want Crystal to
to go to Gladbrook to vote or to Turtle?
Because they're keeping it as a total.
Currently, half goes to Gladbrook and the other half will go to Turtle.
So.
Did we, did that switch when we did?
I'm gonna say it's switched 2 years ago, yeah.
So yeah, so right now, Chris Hall already goes to Gladbrook, so you can keep it the same.
So it would, if we kept it the same, then, as far as balance, would that decrease it? Because if we made anybody in Crystal go to Turtle, we'd create extra.
It honestly wouldn't matter because of the school districts. That, the, when the ballots, when you need more ballots is usually during the school election. So no matter what, there's North Tama people in this township. So whether they go to Gladbrook or whether they go to Traer, it doesn't matter. Because if you send them all to Traer, well then the Gladbrook school district would have to have a ballot there. So it really doesn't matter.
But currently, Crystal, the last voting time went to Gladbrook.
Yep.
No reason to change it.
Change it together, I went north, but if I'd say if it's already there, I wouldn't change it, you know.
If they voted the last time, go into Gladbrook, keep it there.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
It's not broke, don't put it.
Yeah.
So now Howard, which is gonna get split, I would recommend that northern half to go over to Gladbrook.
Right.
And I recommend the lower half to continue to go to Toledo, that's where they currently go. We could do that, or, I mean, you could send them, here's another suggestion, I mean, you could send them to Garwin just because Garwin's gonna be a smaller precinct now. So you could help the poll workers out by sending that half of Howard to Garwin just to help out busyness wise.
The northern half.
The southern half. Because the northern half is in District 3 for supervisor, so they have to go to the District 3.
So they have to go to Gladbrook.
Lower half.
And so it's the lower half, southern, south of Garwin, that would,
Right now they go to Toledo. But I almost would prefer them to go to Garwin just to help out with numbers.
It makes sense.
Because the people in this area.
Right, they're gonna have just a miniscule number now.
You're not talking that great.
Not the same, like someone pointed out, it's not horse and buggy days anymore.
So it's the southern half here.
It's gonna be going down.
It's going down on a tour that used to go to Garwin.
Correct. These people.
Okay.
And then Buckingham.
Those are the ones that get on my case.
Yeah.
Then you have to keep everything contiguous. Also, you can't put an island anywhere.
Correct.
Should help.
What do you think, Mike?
I don't think we have a lot of choice. I think keeping the same voting precincts as much as we can makes the most sense. And that's serving the general public. And that's our purpose. There's no, one thing, there's no gerrymandering in Tama County. Flip a coin. We're not Polk County, sorry folks. And it made no difference in Polk County.
I can see you guys have done a ton of work.
Yes, these two have worked very hard.
The less complaints, the better for me.
And you'll continue to have the work.
Yes.
In developing all these locations and actual knowledge to voters. It creates a lot of expense.
How do you go about informing the people in the areas where they have to go to a different public?
So we'll do publications, and then also we can send out postcards.
And this will take effect January of 2025, so we have time to notify people. After, we'll do it in between, we won't do it. We'll wait till they're done voting at their old precinct, at whatever election that is, which is probably the next general. And then in January, the 25, we'll send out notice. I think that's
Is it 25? I thought the election for five supervisors was next year.
The 24, sorry, I'm a year off.
So you mean January of 2024?
Yes,
okay,
yes,
I was like,
that's right.
So
sorry,
I was like,
yeah, sorry.
In 2024,
got
the district will be
yes.
used for the five board
in,
members.
For that November.
And they'll be
for 24.
That'd be for
years.
Primaries too, wouldn't it?
Is that
yes,
it?
Right. Yes. For the 24.
So they'll all five be elected at the same time?
Yes, and they'll
okay.
be staggered. I think
yeah.
two are for 2 years and
yeah.
three are for
4 years.
And they would take office January of 25.
Yes,
right.
that's where
right.
I
okay.
25.
That'll be for primaries as well, right?
Correct.
Yes.
For all of 24.
Yes.
And there are days to follow as far as those publications. We have to meet the requirements
yeah.
when they're published.
Because then Kurt Wilmer has to run again.
Correct.
Yes, he does.
Correct.
They all have to.
Everybody. All five
yeah.
will get
all,
one.
Yeah.
So do you know which ones have two and which ones have four? How does that
set? I'll have to check with the state on that
yeah.
to determine
I didn't know
how
they do that.
We just draw
a
hat kind of thing. Yeah,
right.
I don't know.
That's crazy.
But I'll definitely check with the state to see
okay.
how to do that.
How long does it usually take to hear back from the state if they accept your proposal?
Last time, 2 years ago, there was we were all behind because the census maps, the Census
slow.
Bureau
yeah.
delayed it.
It was kind of a last minute.
Yeah,
thing
it was
that.
Supposed to be done in December. We didn't get it done until January because we didn't have the information until
so
then.
So you couldn't do it.
So it was fairly quick. So I wonder if that's why they, right. part of the reason why they accepted what we suggested. But I'm hoping they will. I would think within 2 or 3 weeks, I would hope.
Just like that, we've done a labor form, hopefully.
Yeah.
Quick.
As long as it looks good. Just
yeah.
check the
right.
boxes. Did they do this?
Right.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And there won't be as many proposals because 2 years ago it was everybody.
Well,
state redistricting.
If we want to go with
so
this,
a lot.
We're going
yeah,
to put the
yeah.
proposal.
So it'll just be whoever voted
number
for
okay.
increase or decrease there.
Got it.
Yeah, I don't see any other.
Or if the numbers change that much,
yes.
the census.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah
those
well,
outlines on
the I think it's important that we keep the same precincts.
All the roads.
All the precincts.
Yeah,
we're not adding
it.
It's
not practical to add that.
No.
Right.
And we'd have to add it if we went any other way. It's unfortunate, but. You have to follow the law
yeah.
from that point. So I guess we could have a motion of the board. Let's call this proposal final number one. Somebody want to make a motion to approve it?
I'll make a motion.
Moved by Joe.
Second.
Second by Richard. All in favor say aye. Aye. Okay.
Do we need to call out the precincts then with their setting today?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So we'll have... called the southern part of Howard right now since we don't have control on it. So the second half of Howard will go to Garland. And the northern section of York is going to go to Gutierrez.
Crystal will remain going
to Gladbrook. The southern half of Carlton is going to go to Montour. The northern half of Carlton Township is going to go to Gladbrook. The northern half of Howard is going to go to Gladbrook. And Buckingham is going to go to Dysart.
And those are just the differences.
Those are the differences.
Will we meet again then in a week, or do we wait until we get word back from?
Yeah, so what'll happen now, so if you guys are settled on that, I had set a meeting for next week in case we couldn't make a decision
okay.
this week, so we don't need to have that meeting.
Good.
So I will put on the agenda, if one of you wants to come Monday, I'll put on the agenda to, you're going to present your proposal and ask the board to set 3 public hearings. One of you, one or all of you can come. I'll put that on the agenda for Monday, and then the board will set 3 public hearings, and then if one or all of you can come to those hearings in case there's questions, I'll make sure Karen and Maureen are there to answer.
answer specific questions if there are any.
And if you'd like, I could come up with a map more like this, showing
good.
That
that'd be excellent. That'd be very good.
Can you pull up highways on there so I've got people?
Yep. Yeah. We can do that.
Yep. I know I like to come to Monday morning supervisor meetings.
Do you?
Yeah. It's been a
man, we never had anybody show up.
I know.
When I was on the board.
Well,
it was unusual.
Times were different.
Well, no.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's
true.
Always remember Ross Von Speck.
Oh, yes.
Showing
yes.
Up.
You were visiting.
He was fun.
Yep. Then once the supervisors have their three hearings and they approve what you're proposing, then it gets sent to Des Moines.
Okay.
Then we wait to hear from them.
Okay.
I'm hoping to have it all done by October sometime. Our deadline is December. We have an election in November, so we're hoping to get
so
it.
So they can vote on it 3 weeks in succession.
Yes, they can. Yep. Yep. Or if they want, we can do it 3 days in a row, and the supervisors can come in extra days for special meetings. But I don't know that they want to do that. I'll see what they say on
they,
that.
They can't waive the second and third meeting.
Can you
I on this one, I don't think they. I wouldn't recommend that they do
okay.
That. Just so people have, in case they can't come one week, they come another week.
So who wants to come Monday?
I'll be here.
I know, my wife's got a doctor's appointment Monday night. I'd rather not come, let's put it this way. I can't be here if we need $3.
We don't need $3 though for Monday.
Okay.
Yeah. Want to come, Mike?
Well, I'll see you. Again? You're going to be here.
I'll be here.
Yeah. All we do is what?
Present
it to the supervisor.
Present your findings.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Can I get a copy of
it? Yes, you may. Yep. I'll make you a copy before you leave. Yep.
All right. Next. I mean, do we have anything to do with the precinct?
That is, you just said
that. We did that.
Okay.
Yep. We approved
that's what, you, that's what you did. Yep.
By accepting the plan, we accepted the precinct.
And then they called up and they're going to Darwin and.
Because they stayed the same.
Right.
Precinct
well,
the precincts stay the same,
three
but they're where the people are going, some of them have changed. Sure. All right. Yeah.
All right.
Any other business that we need to do?
Not that I'm aware of.
Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Done. Yeah, I'd like to copy. What time are we on? Would be on the agenda Monday.
Let me look at the schedule here.
It's usually when they're doing agenda stuff.
Right. Not as easy as it used to be, right, Joel?
Well, I mean, it's all just Seattle did the work.
Yes.
I
they always did.
I didn't play a lot with it, but I played one night.
No, I played with it, and I couldn't come up with it.
I
went north and south. I tried to do it that way. And I'd get to that fifth district tonight. I'd start from the east, moving across. And,
see,
said, oh, well, that's not bad. And Cameron, that's not
walks.
Bad.
I mean, I ran into that.
Yeah.
I ran into the bank. I ran into
right.
The city, the county. Yeah.
Put you down at 10. Does that work?
10.
Yeah. And then you guys do get paid a per diem and mileage, but I think I'll wait till we're all done.
Sure.
And just do it all at once. In case you do have to.
Thank you.
In case it doesn't get approved if it's right. Rains or something, and then you.
Except for, you know, a couple places.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. researching and.
And the only thing going in, I knew turning Geyser together was too much.
Yeah.
That was gonna have to be split.
And Tama Toledo was too much. They had to be split.
Tama Toledo's gonna be separate.
I'd say Tama by itself is almost too much. Just had to find the right township to throw in.
So that's the, there's a special.
I guess the other question Richard had, what if we wanted to get out of the three district, or Plan Three?
You mean if we want to go back to District Four?
Get out of Plan Three.
Oh, yeah, District Four.
Oh, sorry.
Plan Three is where, you know, separate district.
Right.
Cause I was watching another county was doing a special election and if there was some Plan Three or to the side.
I don't know, like, that's a joke, so I'm like.
I just don't want to say. But I don't know how else, like, if that's, well, it's gonna be town regardless, that's why.
So we could get along.
That makes sense.
Because I had somebody ask.
So do you include town on that when you send it, so they have?
Yeah, yeah.
You'll put all the different townships in town.
I learned from the virus, Ryan said.
Cool. I don't know how any, I don't know why this worked and all.
The labor is not still very high.
I'm sure. I've learned that.
It's like, I'm like, another people there and one outside.
Oh, really?
So hard.
That would be very hard.
It's like, just going up there.
Didn't hear about some counties at some of my meetings that have two precincts.